Matters.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to episode 15 of the Marvel Matters podcast, featuring the spectacular Steve.
Flame on.
The benevolent Ben.
Ben Smash.
The notorious Nate.
It's clobbering time.
And I am your host, the tremendous Tom, and I really can't take you seriously after that.
I genuinely thought I was getting clobbered.
My ears have just popped.
Good. So this week's show is going to be dedicated to Sam Wilson, a.k.a. Falcon, a.k.a. Captain America.
A.k.a.
So that leads us in nicely to our icebreaker, which comes from Tom Epps this week. Oh, that's me, Tom Epps.
Oh, hi, Tom.
And he, oh wait, I mean, I ask, who is your favourite Captain America and why?
Who?
So, I'm not actually here with a bunch of owls. Does anybody want to jump in and...
What?
Let's talk about who are the Captain Americas.
Let's list them, shall we?
Ben was about to say something, I interrupted him. What were you going to say?
No, let's list them first.
Okay.
Steve Rogers, obviously.
Yeah, that's one. You've got the old Winter Soldier, Bucky Barnes.
Then we've got Sam Wilson.
Samwise Wilson.
Got a guy called Roscoe who was killed, but I don't know anything about him.
He's dead now.
Yep. Is it just three or is there four?
Well, Roscoe's dead, so three.
Three.
And who's left now?
There's probably more, but
did we mention the third one?
They're the big three, aren't they? We'll call them the big three.
Sam Wilson is the one.
All right.
We'll call them the big three.
That's what I said. I didn't think anyone said...
Steve Rogers. Oh, well, anyway, let's move on. Who's your favourite out of those three? And why?
Gary Woodside.
Gary Woodside.
Stop bringing Gary Woodside into this every day.
2.5 minutes in, yes.
I think Sam Wilson's my favourite.
Really?
Favourite Captain America?
Yep.
Really? Why is that, Ben?
Well, I just had a little look at him today and I quite like where he was going.
You just like who he is, what he's
where
about?
Where was he going? Was he like on his way to Tesco or something?
Do you know what? I'm going to be inclined to agree with Ben with this.
Yeah.
Do you know why, though? I'm going to give a proper reason, though. Not this I was looking at him today business. Because he hasn't actually got any superpowers. Well, technically he's got one, but it doesn't count. Because he's just like a guy.
He's like Dr. Doolittle.
He can talk to birds, yeah,
he can
right.
talk to the animals.
But other than that, he's just like he's just a dead strong dude who's been working out a lot. And but he fights for good.
He's got a good heart.
Yeah, but the other thing is,
he's really
well,
good
if,
heart.
If he's got a problem, he can sit Plus you down and money. He can talk he to you one-to-one and talk it over.
He didn't always have a good heart, though, did he?
He's on your left, though, isn't he?
To the left.
Yeah, we'll move on to that anyway when we get onto the character. Nate, who's your favourite?
I'll just go with Steve Rogers, because I've not really seen the others that much to have an opinion on it, yeah.
That's fair enough. Is that because Bucky Barnes isn't liked by Black Panther?
Maybe, yeah.
Fair play, mate, fair play.
What about you, Steve?
There is only one Captain America. Steve Rogers.
There can be only one. Thailand now with fight. Captain Americas.
No one is just human.
Steve Rogers.
Well, I haven't seen his catchphrase anyway. All right, fair play. Nobody for Bucky Barnes then. That surprises me.
No, but I'd pick him second if I was picking a top three out of three.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I think I'd pick him second too.
I'd pick him second because I don't I like him.
I'd pick Steve Rogers second to be honest. He's my number three.
You don't want to fight with the Winter Soldier.
Top three Captain America's fair to it first. So let's move on then to this week's
Marvel Kombat!
Round one. Fight.
So last week saw Jean Grey face off against Star-Lord, and it was a landslide for Jean Grey to win. We all voted for him. Nath even voted for him. He doesn't even know that he voted for her, even
nope.
not him.
I voted for him.
And we put it to the Twitter vote, but the Twitter vote was actually quite surprising. Because
bonkers it was.
It was 60-40, but it was still in favour of Jean Grey, but I thought that was still fairly even.
Basically, all Star-Lord's family came out of the closet and voted for him.
Came out of the closet.
Yeah.
Okay, fair enough.
Not like that. Just
maybe all the Nova Corps had voted.
Yeah,
definitely. That's
that
a good
can
shout.
Only be the logical good explanation
right,
for
I
this.
See. That makes sense. That
Plus,
makes
I think
sense.
He did an X Factor style sub story online, and people started seeing it. And it was like, I love fighting.
Nath, would you have chosen Jean Grey as well in that situation?
Jean Grey and Star Lord.
Yeah.
Yeah, probably.
Good choice, because that's what you voted last week.
You mean I already voted?
You're here in spirit anyway. So this week sees Daredevil versus Black Widow. Now this, at first glance, is...
Which Black Widow? Natasha Romanoff?
That's the one. I couldn't think of a name for some reason.
Okay.
This, at first glance, is quite a close bout, but I might argue otherwise.
Oh, here we go.
Let's one of you guys jump in first.
Don't forget, though, we have to pick logically and fairly on not just our favourite. Because
no, I have a logical argument ready here to back me up.
Good.
Don't worry.
Good.
The first of all being that Natasha Romanoff doesn't have any superpowers.
I'll counter that with she's a redhead.
Okay, but she but Daredevil's got a full red suit. He's technically got a red head.
Does she not have any superpowers?
She has like enhanced strength and speed, doesn't she?
I think
didn't, when we looked into her in the top five women show that we did, I think there was some in the what was the school called that she went to, the
Red Room.
That's it.
Yeah,
and I think something happened to her there where she got fed some serum or something that made her a little bit more agile, a little bit quicker. I think they just gave her steds, really, steroids,
performance enhancing drugs.
Whereas Deadpool.
I'm going to do that
all the time. Daredevil obviously actually has a superpower. The fact that he can sense everything around him in real time, and he can act so quickly and agilely against whatever comes at him.
I think this is like, when I look at it, I think they're both quite similar. Mm-hmm. Do you agree?
I think fighting styles, I think they're very similar, aren't they?
Yeah, that's what strikes me. I think it would be a proper like hand-to-hand combat fight.
Close combat.
It
would,
but my argument is that how the hell would Romanov ever be able to hit Daredevil? Because Daredevil can sense that fist coming to him.
Yeah, but he does get it.
He gets it all the time.
Yeah, that's when there's like seven people around him.
Nah, he gets it one-on-one.
He's not that good then, is he?
I've seen five episodes. I've seen five and a half episodes, in fact, and he gets sparked on quite a regular basis.
Gets sparked?
Yeah.
For the audience home, that means he gets beaten up.
No, he doesn't. It just means he gets hit.
Doesn't ask for an electrician to come round.
Punch in the face.
There's an electro doesn't like fire a bolt at him. Okay, right. I'll take your...
He gets hit quite a bit.
Yeah.
And if she's going to hit him with some force...
Well, they do that in the TV show just to, you know, try and make it dramatic.
You're saying that comically and film-wise, he's never, ever been hit?
No,
exactly. Didn't think so. Pipe down.
But
Pipe down
she
over
gets,
there.
Like, she gets it all the time, doesn't she?
She would, do yeah. In the face.
Yeah, but she's got so much soldiers. More to her, though, than just fighting.
And red hair. And tight leather
lycra
clothes.
Stuff.
What else has she got to her, then, eh?
She's got all her tactical, strategic spinous. I don't know what that means, but it sounded
spinous.
Good.
Spinous.
Espionage
spinous.
Skills.
Espionage, that's the one.
Or spinous for
or
short.
Spinous, yeah.
So she's spineless, basically.
Spineless. No, what else? Because I don't really know too much about Daredevil.
Do you want Ben's fat list of the week?
Yeah,
the
come on, let's go. Let's head into
Look
the
archive.
Look at
him, he's like, oh.
It's like he's found his purpose with
here's
this.
Here's what I've got for you.
Here we go.
Who we starting with?
Ex-Black Widow.
Okay.
Because following up from me.
Okay, yeah.
Expert tactician, like you just said.
Yep. Tactical, yeah.
Spineless.
Very tactical.
Is there strategicness on there?
Spinous.
Martial arts.
Not spinous.
Behave you lot. I nearly swore then. Right, now this is something I saw. That she's got slower aging.
Okay, yeah.
Enhanced immune system.
So that'd be good if they're fighting for 37 years. She won't age as much as he will, so he might die naturally quicker.
And that'd be great if Daredevil used poisons, but he doesn't, so...
And then expert marksman and master of like various weapons. Mm-hmm. She does, doesn't she?
Oh, and you forgot spinous.
Oh.
And Iron Man.
Sorry, I starred that one down at the bottom as an important one. Spinous.
You're real spinous.
Thanks.
Right.
Sorry, Nate.
Spinous.
Right, and then I'll do Deadpool next.
Do Deadpool, yep. Daredevil.
Yes, I know. He's at peak human physique.
Yep.
And mental condition.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And blind deck.
He's a lawyer, so he could take her to court if she punched him.
Highly skilled acrobat.
Mm-hmm.
She's one of them as well.
Yeah,
though.
She's definitely one of them.
So you cross throat there, that's like. Right.
Nah, she's not. She's not an acrobat. He's an acrobat. He's more agile than she is.
It's not an agile.
110%
spinous.
He definitely is on that.
Yeah.
And then hand to hand combat, radar sense. Now that's a biggie.
That's the biggie. That's his superpower.
Superhuman senses. And then obviously his specially designed billy club.
Yep. Which he can just smack her in the face.
She hasn't got yet. 5.5 episodes into the TV show.
Don't need it yet, does he?
It's because he's not...
He's getting banged out.
He's not Daredevil yet, where you were up to.
No,
that's why. He's just Matt Murdock.
I know.
Wearing a sock on his head.
Mr. Socko.
Sockhead.
And worst of all, he's put it on backwards.
He's blind.
He's
blind.
Inside out as well.
Yeah, but he's got radar sensors. He should know his socks are on the wrong way around.
He does. He's just being cool.
Romanoff wouldn't do that.
He's making a statement.
One thing that really jumps out to me, this is from watching Daredevil, which I know some of us on this table haven't. He can take a hell of a lot of a beating.
Yep.
I always think he's gonna die, and then next thing you know, boom,
But if they did a Black Widow TV show, you'd see her taking a beating too.
No, but I see her in plenty of films.
Yeah, and she's always the weakest one.
She's going to say you've seen her on Plenty of Fish.
She's a fingernail.
Yeah, it did. Too. She didn't message
Tommy
me back,
swiping,
actually.
Tommy swiping right on that one.
That's Tinder.
Is that the way around? Is that the right way? Do you swipe right or left? I don't know.
Right.
Okay.
What's your fake account say?
Yeah, so... But it's a very good point there, Ben, because Daredevil is renowned for taking a beating. Because he's a Murdoch. He's like battling beats. Jack Murdoch.
You just said he can't get it, and now you're saying he's taking a beating.
Yeah, so
you're saying that he can get it, so I'm just counterpointing that with that if he can get hit, then he can take a beating.
I've got another one for you.
Go on then.
I'm not sure the year's correct, but 2003 Daredevil movie.
Okay.
There you go. End of Romanoff wins.
Friday, I've not actually seen that film.
Oh, wow.
This is
so being disregarded from the court.
This is 13 years on. A lot's happened. A lot's changed.
It has, mate. You're right, yeah. He's actually decent now.
Nath, what are your thoughts on this off the bat?
What, who I choose?
Who, what are you going and saying right now and why?
Black Widow.
Why, what are you saying?
I just think she's got a lot more to her.
See,
probably in a straight up fight, Daredevil will probably win, but I think she's got a little bit more to her.
But this is a straight-up fight.
Yeah, but you know what I mean?
Tom says to you with his Daredevil t-shirt on.
She has got Spinus as well.
Yeah, I think she'll just beat him with a Spinus.
Yeah?
Yeah.
But that's only one letter away from Spineless. So Spineless.
Yeah.
I think when you've seen the TV show... It gives you know more about Daredevil. You see him more fighting, a lot more, and it makes me definitely lean towards him as being better. Because I've seen some of the fights he's been involved in, some of the people he's killed, some of the beings he's taken, and he's pretty tough.
It's just for me. It's literally just the radar sense, the extra sensory perception that he has, is that he can avoid a lot of Black Widow's attacks. Maybe not all of them. He does take a beating every now and again, according to Steve. And
for me, I like on the back of that now, they're going to be fighting hand-to-hand a lot, basically. That's going to be it between them two. And I think for me, the defining factor is that I know Daredevil can take a bigger beating than Black Widow.
Yeah.
So we'll just keep coming back.
Plus,
and eventually,
if he's dodging like 70% of what she's throwing at him, can she do the same? No.
No.
Of course you can.
Nah.
No.
She's got a spine, hasn't she?
Shall we move on then to the vote?
If you would
it
like.
Sounds like we've got some decisions already made here and nobody's willing to sort.
Nate's already voted.
I've already voted.
So we'll start with Nate. Say it officially into the microphone, please.
Officially Black Widow.
Officially Black Widow. She's not in it, just normal Black Widow. Who wants to go next? I'll go next because it's quite cut and dry who I'm going for, and that's Deadpool.
You can't play Captain Marvel now.
That's Deadpool.
I was about to say, remember, it's not Deadpool.
I've been really thinking about it now every time I say the name. Who wants to go next then between you two?
Ben, tell you what to go next.
I'm going to even it up then. Daredevil.
How does that even it up? That makes it 2-1.
Yeah.
It's 2-1 at the minute.
Oh, did Tom vote?
Yeah.
All right, 2-1, we're winning.
2-1, back post header.
Yeah.
Down to Steve then. Dum dum dum.
I knew all along I was going to vote for. I was just trying to provide an argument.
You can't vote for Captain America this time, all right? You've already had that one.
I'm about to change my vote just because I don't like your tone. I'm voting Daredevil.
Good man.
Yes.
So he's Daredevil through.
Can I say why?
Yeah, go on then.
Because, again, because I've seen the TV show, well, a lot more of it now than I had last week. He's unbelievable, the type of things he can do, and there's so much more to him than what you actually think, and that's not disregarding Black Widow in any way, shape or form. But
no, I should say that I've been very Daredevil friendly this time. I had to really think about what I was saying then, but I do think that Black Widow is a really
and
good
and I think
what she
in
does.
A Twitter poll I think we'll find that this one will go the other way.
I think we'll say the other way.
She's got such a core,
that's why I'm so glad you said Daredevil,
such a core following of people that I think that other people disagree with us, what we're saying, but currently, again, we are probably swayed by the fact it's been on the telly recently and we've seen it. And obviously, you've got all your professional, like your proper deep comic book fans out there that all say this and that, and they'll have all these reasons, which is fair enough, but we don't know those reasons. For we're only saying it as we are sat here.
Exactly.
When I looked at him, like, over the last week, I must admit, I always thought it was going to be close, but I knew that I favoured probably Daredevil a little bit. Initially, I thought Daredevil. But then when I was reading the stuff this week, it's brought it a lot closer together for me.
Yeah.
And like somebody could have said something at this table that had really like swayed my decision either way, really. Mm-hmm. But I think it was pretty close to
it. I think if I hadn't watched Daredevil, started to watch Daredevil in the last 7 days,
yeah,
if we'd have done this, if this was the first battle out, mm-hmm, I think it could have been a very different outcome.
Yeah, as I said all the way through this, it's just the fact that he has a superpower and that superpower can make him dodge a lot.
Can I ask one question without spoilers about the TV show while we're talking about it?
Sure.
Does Elektra turn up?
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Not in this season, though.
Yes.
I know that.
Okay.
Thanks.
And yes. She's.
Who's next week,
character.
Tom? Who's next week?
Next week's bout is.
Who?
The Hulk.
Who? Hulk Smash.
The Incredible Hulk.
Who?
Versus.
Who?
Taskmaster. So, you know, last week when we said that Jean Grey versus Star Warlord was the only one sided one we thought there was?
Nah, man, this isn't one sided at all.
Okay.
Tony Masters has got skills.
He's got the.
He's got a particular set.
He's got the Eye of Thundera.
Okay, well, that's cool. We'll put the poll for Daredevil versus Black Widow on Twitter and see what you guys think. Hopefully you'll agree, but you probably won't.
I just pressed draw on OneNote to see what the draw was for Mortal Kombat, but it doesn't do that. just so you know.
I was just thinking, does this mean like Daredevil's going to go up potentially against...
That's what I was trying to look
the
at.
...the next
who,
fight,
who,
or has he already got...
No,
his...
he will go up against Hulk.
What?
Eh?
I mean, if Hulk
what?
Wins...
What? I thought... Oh.
Right.
That's if Hulk wins, should I add.
Tom should be barred from voting now after doing that. That sounds like it's a fix to me.
Yeah.
Wait, you didn't let me finish. Hulk or Taskmaster.
Edit that out.
Anyway, let's move on quickly to the main theme of the show, and that is Sam Falcon Wilson. Ooh. Or possibly Captain America, I suppose. So we basically decided to do a show where we dedicate to a character and we'll just make it kind of an expanded character of the week kind of format. And because of how awesome he was in Civil War, we all decided that it would be great to look into everything that is Sam Wilson.
It was pretty awesome.
So let's start by looking at his origin, because his origin, I found when I was doing research, is kind of confusing because there's a couple of contradicting things, which obviously there always is with origins, but this sounded like it was from the same comic series, but it was written differently in a couple of different places that I read. So what did you guys find out about his origin?
Basically, he was cast off to an island with a man called John Locke and some black smoke.
No, that's Lost.
Oh, right, sorry. Sorry, that was the other one that I read.
That's
halfway
not
there.
Shall I just say what I found out then?
Same thing, really.
He was born in Harlem, for one. That's a definitive fact. His father was a priest, minister.
Or a minister, priest, or whoever he was, yeah.
Who was killed trying to break up a fight. And his mother also died from... She got mugged. Two muggers killed her.
Yeah.
And he wound up on this island because he moved away from Harlem to somewhere that I can't remember off the top of my head. And he basically moved into a life of crime, and he had this other persona called Snap. He called himself Sam Snap Williams. But he wound up on this island when his plane crashed. He was on a plane to somewhere else.
With a fat millionaire called Hurley?
No. And fat's not a political correct term. Thank you.
Was Hurley a millionaire?
Sorry, Hurley.
Was Hurley a millionaire?
I'm fat.
Weight challenged.
Depends what you make up to.
So that's how he wound up there. But then you have the fact that this island that he crashed on was basically owned by Red Skull. And Red Skull had trapped all of his henchmen there, which had formed a group called the Exiles.
Yeah.
And he then used a cosmic cube to wipe Falcon's memory to make him think that he was an upstanding citizen and that Captain America was actually a bad guy.
Yeah, didn't he make him like a social? He think he was a social worker?
No, he was a social worker, wasn't he?
No, it's the other way around. This is what the confusion was, because that website you were reading today is what I read. And I read two other websites, and the other two websites said that it's his fake past that was created by the cosmic cube.
You're saying that's wrong.
And the criminal past was actually his actual past. Because later on, he remembers that and carries on and carries on being a hero rather than going back to his criminal roots.
Whether as a superhero or in his secret identity of social worker Sam Wilson, the Falcon dedicates his life to standing up for others. Marvel.com.
His secret identity. Right, so that's probably, again, another origin, because there's obviously several different origins.
I've read that he is a social worker. This is why I said before, when we were talking about him, that he would sit you down and talk to you.
I thought...
Right, I see.
Because he's a nice guy, isn't he? Yeah,
he's
just
a nice guy.
When I looked at it, I thought that Red Skull had done this thing with his mind and, like you say, made him think that Captain America was the enemy.
Yep.
And he'd given him, I don't know why, but he'd given him this sort of thing that he was a social, he thought he was a social worker.
Yeah, that's what I read.
And then, later on, he went to do, like, social workery stuff.
So in what you read, where does it come out? In what you've read, do mm-hmm. Captain America and the Red Skull swap bodies?
Yes.
Right, because that's obviously that's what Red Skull does, is they swap bodies and he ends up beating on Captain America.
Yeah, that was in the video me and Nath watched earlier, but I don't know if that was actually on the websites that I read, because what that me and Nath watched was, I think, was his original origin, because it's from like 1969.
Captain America 117, 118 and 119.
And that's where he literally meets Falcon, the actual Red Wing Falcon on that island as well, isn't he?
Yeah.
And he uses the Cosmic Cube to form a link between the two, and that's where he gets his superpower from, to actually talk to birds. Yeah. And he forms this really strong link with Red Wing.
Which I didn't know his name was Red Wing until the film.
Oh, yeah?
Obviously, the robot was called Red Wing, which I thought was a nice touch.
Awesome. Do you know what? I didn't even click on that.
No, it's a good touch. That is.
When I saw it today, I was like, no way. And everything they said from the video I watched earlier, because I watched one when I was at work. Yeah. I was working, but yeah.
just on his dinner break. In case anyone's listening.
Yeah.
Sorry, boss.
No, it clicked, like, when he was on about Red Wing. I was like, no way. As if that's the whole...
And then
the whole... Obviously, using Red Wing to see.
Yeah, you can see through the eyes.
Through the eyes of
that's
Red
really
Wing.
Cool.
And it's cool how he has a drone of it, and he can
it's
see
the same,
through
it's the
drone.
Yeah, yeah.
I think it's well cool.
Yeah. So I never even realised that until right now. That's awesome. That's a brilliant.
It's
like,
not, it's not just limited to that bird though either. Yeah. It's all birds all
you
over.
Go through there. Red Wing.
Does that include the one-eyed raven?
Yeah. That's Game of Thrones.
Sorry.
Why are you bringing all these references to the table?
I just like
today?
To bring them.
Bring Marvel references. That's what
I've
we want.
I've got one. Do you reckon you control Pidgeotto? Just to bring in some
Pokemon Go.
Definitely.
Yes, it's a bird type Pokemon, so. Wait, yes.
There's a Snorlax in the conservatory.
There's not, by the way, if anyone turns up here. There is no Snorlax in my conservatory.
I'm just going to go and catch it, though.
So there's kind of some discrepancies there in his origin. Which, again, is probably just the way it's been told different ways. It could even just be the interpretation from the people who've written on the website. You've obviously got that from Marvel.com, but it says that he has a secret identity of a social worker. That doesn't mean that he's carried on his life as a social worker because he's been thinking that he's one.
No, I think he is a social worker. I'd go to him for some social work.
Yeah?
Yeah.
That's because Red Skull gave him some training in his fake identity.
Again, if you watch...
Identity.
Oh, what was it? I say I've read different ones over the... Oh, I've always known the one, and then that sort of got a bit clouded this week looking into it.
Yep.
And one of the videos I watched on YouTube did say there are several different adaptations of his origin.
Yeah.
And it stated that at the start with like a little disclaimer type thing.
What if he hadn't got the prior qualifications before he met Red Skull, but he did then turn out to still be a cracking social worker?
No, what he'd done though
still
is
go
to him. It says on the Marvel website he'd got an MVQ level 3 in social work.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
One thing that does kind of stay common throughout every single origin that I read
is his name Falcon.
That's true, but
what
also
about his name being Sam Wilson?
And that.
That's true.
And
as well.
He's Marvel's first black superhero, really.
And also that's true. However, is that he gets his actual Falcon wings from Black Panther.
Black Panther,
I knew Nate was Black. When I saw that, I thought Nate is going to love this.
And they obviously gave him the ability to fly, and they're made out of vibranium.
You take these broken wings.
You always have to go there with a song, don't you? I love it, secretly.
Before we move on a little bit,
Nate wants to talk about Wakanda for a minute.
I want to talk about them wings for a bit. No, I'm joking. In one of the videos that I watched, he said that Red Skull has a mask.
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, he does, because he doesn't just walk around with like a Red Skull all the time.
Well, I'm just thinking of the film,
It's made of super glue.
Yeah, in the film, he looks like... he's the guy who plays...
like he's been in the sun too long.
He looks like Agent Smith out of Thingy. But he has a normal face for the first half of that film. It's only in that fire that his mask gets burnt away and you can see his red skull.
Right, okay. So he has a mask of an actual real human face rather than a red
face. It must be like some vibranium prosthetics or something. Yeah.
For adamantium. I just don't know that.
It looks pretty good anyway, so...
Yeah.
Can I just say as well, what I heard, what was your idea of the way that they got him to the island? They made him think he was a...
It was a plane crash.
All right, now you see that what I've read there and what I've always understood it to be was that they tricked him because he was a trainer of Falcons, and they'd put an advert out.
Yeah,
the Exiles had put an advert out for a Falcon trainer, and they'd lured him there to go and be a paid Falcon trainer on the island.
Yeah.
And basically, then once he got there, they enslaved him to make him do it.
I watched that on that video. I think wasn't that on there earlier?
His CV actually got rejected by the HR department, though, so he never went.
Totally was.
Yeah, so then he got on the plane.
He'd done a joint honours degree in falconry and social work.
And Pidgeotto's, because he had a pigeon coop on top of his roof as well. Fact.
There you go.
So talking about the birds and everything, in the origins that I read is that...
Black Widow. No, not that type of bird. Oh, right, yeah.
Not the ladybird.
My bad.
Wait, the ladybird's an actual thing.
He can't control them.
He's always had a love for falcons. Like when he was young, they had the largest chicken coop. No, he had the largest.
Anyone know nuggets?
Pigeon coop, and he's always had like an affinity with the birds.
Walk around egging people.
But he's always had a fascination with falcons, so that's kind of where his love for Red Wing came from. After he became Falcon in the comics, stayed around as sort of Captain America's sidekick for a long time. I don't know if he ever had his actual own comic line as Falcon. Does anybody, Steve, have you read anything about that? Or
I know he had a clothing line.
A clothing line?
Just sounded funny, didn't it? You're supposed to laugh, but you didn't.
Okay.
I think he got proper mainstream when he got his wings.
Yeah.
From what I see.
All the comic book covers that I've got on different canvases and different posters and different everything, it's always Captain America and Falcon.
Right. Yeah, when he got his wings.
Yeah,
he was
sorry. Now you've just said that. I think after this happened, didn't they then have the comic book together, them pair running as...
In the Captain America series, though.
And yeah.
Right, yeah. That's what I've read. I have not read anywhere that to be fair, with the amount of comics that there are out there, he's probably had at least a mini-series at some point on his own.
Well, his first appearance and his origin were both in Captain America comics.
Right, okay.
From 1969, 1-7.
And we know that he's been the focus of one comic series after he became Captain America, and that was obviously the Captain America series. So that kind of moves us on nicely to how did he become Captain America? So did anybody research this?
I don't know.
There's another advert.
I saw an advert in the
news saying they wanted a Captain America.
Is there variance to this, or is there only the one way?
I've only read the one way.
Or another.
And that was when he went up against a character called... Iron Nail, I think it was. He had a longer name, but I think he was called Iron Nail, who was working for another character called Zola.
He looked mentally. I saw that, actually. He looked well cool.
And basically, I might be getting this guy's name wrong, because I didn't write this down like I normally do.
Gianfranco.
But Iron Nail... had these tentacles that were designed to extract the super soldier serum from
Steve Rogers.
Or just anyone's body, but it's obviously meant for Steve Rogers. And Steve Rogers had to basically infiltrate this... S.H.I.E.L.D. had made this big, massive helicopter, but I guess it's more like a helicarrier, that Zola basically stole and turned into like a giant robot, which was basically about to destroy the whole of America.
Yeah.
But Captain America was the only one, because... Falcon basically got taken out. One of his wings broke. There was somebody else with them called Jet, which was Zola's daughter.
Yeah.
But she was like romantically attached to Falcon. And she was also, I think she'd been kind of knocked out or something like that. So it was just down to Captain America. And even though he kept dodging these tentacles, he kept fighting, kept dodging them, and he was doing really well. And he got to like the last bit where he used to shut the robot down. And what the tentacle literally got him in the back as he was about to throw his shield.
Yeah.
And so it sucks all the sort of superpower out of him, and in his last act as a super soldier, he chucked his shield and broke the big robot, which was called Gungnir, by the way.
Yeah.
Which we mentioned that we didn't really know anything about in our artifacts episode. So that
Ran,
was...
Ran Shen, his name was.
Ran Shen.
Yeah. I've just cheated.
He also called Iron Nail.
I googled it. But yeah, Iron Nail. But if you look at
right,
the
guy, okay, Ran Shen.
He looks totally different in his two different names.
He has a mask. He has like an alien mask. And when that comes off, yeah, he looks just like a normal guy.
He looks like a samurai. And then he looks like some crazy beast.
Yeah, exactly. That's like a mask that he's wearing. He has like an alien sort of mask.
A mask and a crazy different body. This guy looks scary.
Yeah, he has like this weird thing that comes out of his chest as well.
Thanks, Google.
But yeah, so but Captain America is still alive. He's just really old and he has no power.
Yeah.
So after that happens, he still works with the Avengers. But Falcon doesn't become Captain America straight away. Just no. Steve Rogers stops being Captain America. Further down the line, Falcon is working with the Avengers, and to save Captain America and Agent Carter and their son, because their son, they also have a son, he basically takes this bomb that's threatening them to kill them all, and he takes it up into the sky to get it out of harm's way, and it blows up. Everyone thinks that he's dead.
Yeah.
But he used his vibranium wings to protect himself, and that is when Steve Rogers then says...
Iron Man was there, actually, wasn't he? Because he takes it up in the air, I saw, and then... Like, everyone's like, don't do it, you're going to die, sort of thing. Yeah. And then, like, you say he blows up, and then Iron Man catches him, doesn't he?
Exactly.
And he says, I save myself using the wings.
Yeah, because then that's when Steve Rogers then steps in and says, I'm still going to work with the Avengers.
But just, like,
yeah,
admin.
Just he becomes the leader of
doing
the Avengers,
paperwork.
Basically.
But doesn't he have something to do with S.H.I.E.L.D. as well?
I think doesn't he become the director of S.H.I.E.L.D.?
I think he has something to do with S.H.I.E.L.D.
I read that he became the director
of S.H.I.E.L.D. Years. I think he has something to do with S.H.I.E.L.D. I think it's quite involved with that, I think.
I assume that he gets his Super Soldier Serum back later on.
eBay.
Yeah. Okay, that's good.
He keeps getting outbid
at the
moment.
It's amazing what you get on eBay, isn't it, really? Yeah, so I thought that was pretty cool of how he became Captain America.
There's a pair of vibranium rings on eBay at the moment.
Is there? Are you going to buy them?
$699. Buy it now.
Nate's currently watching them.
The Mandarin rings.
The Mandarin.
No, I think it's pretty cool how he becomes Captain America. I didn't know the way about how Steve Rogers sort of lost his.
No, I didn't until
like,
I read
which I think is quite good. Like when I read it, like you say, he gets this sort of serum sucked out of him.
So just going back to his wings then for a second, I just think it was interesting how different the comic book origin of his wings were from the film. Because obviously in the film, where did he get his wings from in the film? Can anyone remember?
They were like some task force, weren't they?
Was it
he was
like,
part of like a team that quite a few of them had them, I think. And he was the only
just
one
two
left.
Of them? Didn't they say that there was two of
partner
them?
Oh, yes. Yeah, partner. And that's the bit of a story, wasn't it? Because he died or something, didn't he?
Is that what it was?
Yeah.
Right.
I think so. Because then he gave up. What was he doing when... Because there's that scene where like Steve Rogers is chatting to him in Captain America. And they were like, I can't remember.
Is
what
it the
was.
Start of the Winter Soldier, wasn't
he's,
it? Where
he's
in like the group.
Does he do he like teaches or helps people recover
he runs
from psychological?
Yeah, yeah.
He's a lot different, isn't he? Like his origin in the film is like you say, totally different. As in, he's just like a soldier basically.
Yep.
In the films, whereas in the comics, it's totally different, and he's got such a better origin, in my opinion.
Yeah, yes, and he stands for like a lot more, because that was another thing about his origin, about his original origin, was that he was enslaved in that village, but Steve Rogers says that he needs to become a symbol of like hope or something, doesn't he, to try and rally their support or something like that.
Yeah.
So he becomes this icon of standing for like what's right and doing what's right, even though he doesn't really have any major superpowers or anything like that.
Yeah.
So you don't really see that, do you, in the films? But there's not really been any focus on him enough for that to happen yet, I don't think.
I like the fact he had a bit of a bad streak as well, of being a criminal.
Yeah. It kind of adds a bit more depth to the character, doesn't it?
He had a big part in the Civil War in the films as well. I think it's brilliant.
One of the things I'd read as well was about something to do with the Sentinels.
Oh, yeah.
In one of the storylines, one of the Sentinels had chased him down thinking he was a mutant.
Mm-hmm.
And I think they were the writers were going to go down the road of making him a mutant.
Right,
and they sort of like debunked it and went, oh, no, the robot's broke. It wasn't really that.
Yeah, I think I read that, actually.
I was reading about it today at work, actually. Mm-hmm.
Maybe
my dinner break.
Maybe it'll be a new moon.
New moon.
How many times have we said that now?
I just love it. I listen to that podcast regularly.
Also,
every day.
The Pops. You've seen the new Papa Falcon that's coming out is the old classic Falcon.
Classic Falcon. Yeah.
So you've got the two versions of his wings and his outfit, his suit. Mm-hmm. So obviously that, like you were saying before, the difference between the two.
Yeah, so you can kind of see the big difference there between them, can't you? Because his suit in the films is much more of a modern-day version.
Yeah, it's all slick and sort of, like, tight and
even the fashion sense is a lot more kind of...
But in one of the comics as well that I was looking at was about... showed his very, very early suit, if you like. I use the word suit very loosely, but... when he was on the island.
Is that the green one?
Yeah, the green one. Yeah. Like the face paint, like the Ultimate Warrior.
Yeah, he did, didn't he? He looked like, what was it? Was it Coco Beware?
Yeah, he looked a bit like that.
Because he had a parrot as well, didn't he?
Yeah. So that was obviously, I presume that was probably his first suit.
Yeah.
If you like, but yeah, he's obviously had a couple of different ones.
He's had a few upgrades since then.
But his one in Civil War is definitely the one.
Yeah, definitely. I definitely
thanks
agree.
To Nafe's mate, sorting him out some wings.
Cheers, Black Panther.
No problem.
Just tell him. Just tell him that we said thanks when you speak to him.
I will do. I'll text him in a minute.
Thanks, mate.
Just say, look, cheers to Charla.
Come on the show.
Makes me call him.
We'll call him up sometime on the show. And,
still makes me call him King, though, doesn't he?
Kingy.
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 Speak to his nan, actually, a lot as well.
So, do you think that Falcon is the kind of character that we might possibly see a solo film of in the future?
I would have definitely said no. Until recently,
mm-hmm.
whereas I still think I'm inclined to say no.
Yeah.
But I do think he will have had a lot more fans from Civil War.
Yeah.
And me looking at his origin and us doing this, mm-hmm. I definitely think I like him a lot more than I did.
Yeah.
And like I think I might have even said he was going to die in the Death Sweep or said he should have done because he was like a side, you know, like a side character. Mm-hmm. So he was in it, but you could have got away with killing him. Now I think, like, no way. I think I really like him. I want to know more about him.
I think his origin story, from what I've been reading, is quality. They should have done an origin of him along the same time as Captain America and then introduced him that way. Because I reckon it would have worked with Red Skull and his henchmen on the island, etc. Mm-hmm. I think
he'll be heavily involved with the new Avengers. Like, you know, when we're talking, was it last week about the new... It was last week. I think he'll be heavily involved with that. But it'll be interesting to see which way they go with it, because obviously all this talk about film deals and everything else and moving the franchise forward.
Mm-hmm.
I would imagine at some point they're going to do a new Captain America
in
the MCU.
Mm-hmm.
But obviously you've got both of the other guys in play.
Yeah.
So who are they going to pick? Which way are they going to go with it? Will they pick Bucky or will they pick Sam Wilson?
That's a very good point, yeah.
Obviously, everyone says, oh, yeah, it's going to be Winter Soldier.
Well,
but
before we've done this research as well, we've always said, haven't we? We've always said that we think he's going to be the next one.
He's going to pass the mantle on to the Winter Soldier.
I just got this really cool image of him and his wings carrying that shield round. I just think it'd be sick.
Oh, there's some of the pictures from the comics with the stripy costume and the star in the middle.
That would be pretty cool, actually.
The wings as well.
Because
he's got the shield
from his wings anyway, hasn't he?
He looks with a shield.
That'd be epic.
He also, in the comics, has a bit of... I don't know any details, but I know that he has a bit... One of the storylines in it is that he has a beef with Baron Zemo.
Yes.
From what
I could tell, that's kind of his main... one of his main bad guys. One of his main villains is Baron Zemo.
So obviously that... again, could tie in with where the MCU is going, potentially.
Yeah, in the cinematic universe, we have this whole mystery of his partner, because we've only had snippets of what happened in the past. So when we're talking about who his partner could possibly be, and we've mentioned that perhaps that's Vulture that might be in Spider-Man.
We just made that up, by the way, and then went with it. Imagine if that happens.
So maybe, again, he definitely has the potential and the possible storyline there for him to have a film focused on him. But again, I think he probably needs a bit more development in like an Avengers setting. So maybe after Infinity Wars, ready for the new Avengers. So when they're going to get into that. So that would be kind of, I think that'd be cool.
I vote for that, yeah.
Yeah.
I'd see that. I think that's the way they'll go, though. I think he will be a heavier role in the new Avengers.
I'm really excited to get to that, but it's going to be like another 10 years.
I think I'm a bit upset that he did get his butt kicked by Ant-Man. In the Ant-Man film. But I think he'd probably take him down now after Civil War.
I don't know, when he goes into the giant man. We're making our own Marvel Kombat about you.
Come on, if he's going to be the next Captain America, he's got to be like pretty much the ultimate fighter in Steve's eyes anyway.
Well, that's the other magical thing about him is that he isn't, is he? He's not got super soldier serum. He's just a guy at his physical peak who can talk to birds. I mean, actual birds, not like women.
He'd be a great wingman, put it that way.
That's
so funny in so many different ways.
Take it how you want it.
On that note, let's move on to an actual female character. So it's time for this week's Character of the Week.
Character of the Week.
So Ben, it was your turn to choose this week, and you chose Squirrel Girl.
Fool.
Yes.
Unfortunately, yes, you chose Squirrel Girl.
Don't be like that, Tom.
You know my feelings on Squirrel Girl.
We didn't moan when
you chose Squirrel Girl.
Tom.
Him over there.
Ben. You're a right nutter, you are.
You squirreled that joke away, didn't you? So, Ben, would you like to start by telling us your facts and then we will add ours?
Okay. So, Doreen Green, Squirrel Girl.
One name.
First appearance, Marvel Superheroes Volume 2, Episode 8. So, her, a little bit about the origin that I saw for her was she was escaping the taunts of fellow school students regarding her physical mutation. Los Angeles-born Doreen Green fled into the nearby woods where she quickly discovered her affinity for squirrels. Idolizing Iron Man, she adopted the custom identity of Squirrel Girl in the hope of becoming his crime-fighting partner.
Ooh. Ooh.
Upon finally meeting him, she single-handedly defeated Iron Man's nemesis, Doctor Doom, overwhelming him with squirrels under her control. That's nevertheless,
so
I know, yeah.
That's so ridiculous.
I was loving it, I was. Where is she in Marvel Kombat? I was like, so, nevertheless, Iron Man declined her offer of partnership. Iron Man stated that she was too young to fight crime. He will put a good word in for her with the Avengers when she is older.
So I take it that she was probably at the X-Men Academy then, the Xavier's Academy.
No, I don't think she's there. I think she's just, I assume, just at some
sort of thing.
Normal student at a normal school, because it never mentioned that when I looked at it.
Right, I was surprised to learn that she is actually a mutant.
Oh, I was, when I saw that, I was like, that could turn Tom.
I don't want to talk about her.
I think she's a boss.
She makes me really angry.
Me too. So,
honestly, I can't tell you how I feel.
I actually quite liked about it when I read it.
I'm bubbling. I read it and I was like, is that all you've got for me? Is that it?
So,
there's nothing there.
Let me carry on.
Sorry, mate. Apologies.
Squirrel Girl subsequently moved to New York to fight crime, earning quite the reputation in Central Park's greatest protector. There, Green was recruited into the would-be super team, Great Lake Avengers, helping them defeat Maelstrom and his agents, Batroc's Brigade, although during this time she had to deal with losing her most trusted squirrel companion, Monkey Joe.
Oh no, not Monkey Joe.
Enough said. Doesn't he wear a certain shirt and tie?
Does he?
Is that
him?
Is Monkey Joe the big monkey with the shirt and tie?
No, he's not a big monkey, he's a squirrel.
He's a squirrel.
Oh, there is. All right, there is a big ape or monkey. I'll find it now.
Okay, so yeah, she lost a squirrel buddy, Monkey Joe. He was killed by Leather Boy.
Leather Boy
just gets better.
Is he made out of leather?
I hope so. In the wake of the distraught battle against Maelstrom, Squirrel Girl adopted a new sidekick, calling her Tippy Toe. After discovering that Squirrel Girl was a mutant, the other members found that they shared this commonality, after which they changed their name to the Great Lakes X-Men to avoid a lawsuit, basically. So, from here, with a mixture of success, pluck, and a cheery smile, Squirrel Girl has quickly become a favoured ally of S.H.I.E.L.D., but she declined the opportunity to be a deputising agent, preferring her own team. Months before, however, she long wanted to join the New Warriors when they first appeared in a particular due to her obsessive crush with Speedball.
So she just wanted to join the New Warriors because she fancied Speedball, basically.
There's always a love interest in Marvel, isn't there?
That's true. First it's Tony Stark, and then it's Speedball. I don't know anything about Speedball.
No, neither do I.
But don't do Speedballs.
I'll jump straight into my fact, because my fact is basically just a list of her powers. So, her powers are enhanced strength, speed, agility, and reflexes. She has small claws and enlarged incisors, retractable knuckle spikes. She has a large squirrel tail, an empathic bond with squirrels, which allows her to communicate with them.
And so she's like Ant-Man, but not as good.
She's just awful.
No, she's not.
I've
my fact here, which I've kind of realised now after you've read it, is pretty much what you said, but I'll elaborate on it a little bit more because I watched a video on it.
Do it.
So when you said how Squirrel Girl met Iron Man was actually testing a new upgrade on his suit flying through a forest.
Right.
Because basically he wanted to be able to see without being able to see. So if anything happened and his eyes or his suit like got damaged, his suit could navigate and see wherever he was going.
Right, yeah.
So Squirrel Girl, using her powers, snuck up on Iron Man.
Right.
Without him knowing, because obviously he was testing this thing and he was like well impressed with her and this, that and the other.
Yeah.
I don't know how, but Doctor Doom appeared in the woods, just like, oh, hi, I'm just going to kill you now.
Maybe he was
like,
looking for Pokemon.
Like, yeah, maybe he was after a...
Saw a Snorlax appear.
Yeah, Diglett.
He was after a Diglett. So Doctor Doom somehow was trying to kill Iron Man, so they got him in his spaceship, and he was just going to dump him in the sea, and Squirrel Girl was obviously with him. And she somehow, I didn't quite get the story how they managed to do it, because she summoned a load of squirrels, didn't she? I don't know how, if she did it before they were flying, or
it was why they were flying.
So how did the squirrels get on?
Like, they didn't tie her up or anything, because Dr. Doom just laughed at her. Yeah. She thought she was a bit of a joke. And
I agree with Dr. Doom.
As the ship, mate, this is ace.
Passed through a wood.
She'd already called them, and they were ready.
She called them from the ship, and then they basically jumped into the ship.
Yeah, and they chewed all the wires up and everything, and they overpowered Dr. Doom. Because if he chucked one off, another 10 appeared on him.
Yeah.
So then instead, he just couldn't control it, so he just jumped off the ship.
He just like legged it.
Yeah, basically.
She's not to be overlooked in the Marvel Universe.
She's an idiot.
Do you know why that is? Because the writers.
I like Steve's, sir. I like Steve's fact here. It's very good.
I was struggling. I'll be honest. She's got nothing that I want to say about her. So I just went with, this is just an example of how poor she is. Her belt holds many pouches for her nuts, which she can consume for extra energy. Macadamia nuts give her an extra boost.
She keeps a well-balanced diet.
I can't really relate to her on that with having a nut allergy, but I can just take her word for it.
She goes nuts like macadamia.
So you shouldn't like her either, because you're allergic to her.
I think I'm allergic to her.
I just think it's ridiculous. Like, I understand why it's a niche, and I understand why she's got a cult following because of her plucky attitude and just of how ridiculous the storylines are, but they're just way too ridiculous
for
me.
She's up there with Ryzo Kodo for me.
I didn't really like her, obviously. I've got the pop of her recently because it was an exclusive one in the boxes. I wanted to know about her because we've mentioned her a few times and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
And I thought she's quite interesting. Like, there's a couple of other things that I've wrote here.
She beat Thanos as well, didn't she?
Yeah.
This is what I'm getting onto.
And Deadpool.
Absolutely beat Thanos. Yeah, and Deadpool.
So let me just tell you then, because you're just going to ruin it now.
Sorry. Can I go?
No. So she defeated Deadpool, MODOK, Wolverine, normally... Which
that's all because none of them are like a woman. Okay.
That was very venomous.
Yeah, that was very... All right, Steve.
Sorry, mate.
So it's normally, like we've just mentioned, is that because of like the overconfidence and the sort of arrogance of who she's coming up against, they sort of like do take her as a bit of a joke. That
underestimate
she always, that she always wins. That's what I saw.
Mm-hmm.
But there was one that particularly caught my eye where she's fighting a guy called Bi-Beast.
Okay.
And what happened is Bi-Beast was fighting against the Thing.
Yeah.
And they were like having quite a close battle.
Mm-hmm.
So she thought, you know what? I'm going to help the Thing out here.
Mm-hmm.
So what she did is she summoned all her squirrels to bring a load of garbage and rubbish to like where they were fighting. And then Bi-Beast had to use both of his hands to hold his nose because it was so smelly that then the Thing, then the Thing could actually defeat him. Which I thought was absolute genius.
Do you know what? You're making it worse.
No, I'm not.
You're not making it any better for me.
That is brilliant.
I just find it crazy how she just beat Thanos. And it was actually Thanos.
It's going to take all the Avengers to beat Thanos. Yeah, Squirrel Girl
does it on her own.
If you just give her a call, she'd help him out. So yeah, she defeated Thanos, like you just said.
She got a squirrel copter.
She's... No.
She doesn't need one, mate.
She's got a tail swing around. Tails. Sonic and Tails.
And then she's also defeated Galactus.
Oh, yeah, of course she has. Yeah,
I say defeated loosely because what actually happened is she sort of befriended him.
Led him on and then got him arrested.
Befriended him.
Bang out of order.
And then convinced him not to destroy Earth.
Yeah.
But when they first actually met, when she did actually try and hurt him, but then she just decided to convince him. And she basically saved the world.
Did she find Thanos on Tinder? Casually, because she shouldn't even. How much she makes me anxious.
If you check Thanos' Facebook page, he's actually in a relationship.
Yeah, and she also has the name of Unbeatable because of all the people that she's beaten.
Can we talk about someone else now?
Basically,
else?
I've just also thought what we'll do is we'll stop doing Marvel Kombat now and we'll just announce Squirrel Girl the winner.
She's not even in it. She didn't even qualify, mate. She got knocked out in the qualifiers by Andy Murray.
She was on the same level as Galactus. And
she's just
a guy that
she's unbeatable. She can't enter, can she? It's not fair.
So, how'd you like those apples?
Also, there was kind of an implication that she may have been in a relationship with Wolverine at some point.
Yeah, I saw that.
That's disgusting. Wolverine's an old guy.
Will you stop making jokes?
Both animals, though, aren't they?
I don't like it. I honestly... Oh, man.
Okay, Steve, just for you.
I just wish he was drawn against Captain America in the next round because...
One winner.
Not only would I have a vote for Squirrel Girl, but the rest of Twitter would follow me in.
That's because all the bloody squirrels would be voting on the mobiles.
She'd just summon the squirrels to vote. Monkey
Tom,
Joe.
Take control of this podcast quick.
I'm liking what Ben's saying, to be honest. So before we move on to the news then, next week is Nate's turn to choose.
Ooh, and he's going to choose Monkey Joe.
Tippy toe. Monkey Joe.
So Nate.
Any monkey, Steve.
Who are you going to choose?
I've gone for a villain again.
A villain again? Oh,
I don't
like
know if
a
any
villain,
of you,
man,
any of you have heard him, but he looks pretty good. And I think you'll like him.
Okay. It's not the Wrecker, is it?
No, it's called Blackheart.
We've done him.
No, you haven't.
Blackheart.
You missed
Blackheart.
I've never heard of him. Have you heard of him? No.
He's very supernatural.
Ah.
He's got a heart.
Magical.
Is he a Doctor Strange villain?
Nope.
Does that mean, yep?
Nope.
You don't know, do you?
I don't know. I'm saying, well, I had a little look at him and he looks pretty good.
All right, cool. So next week's character of the week is going to be Blackheart. So now let's move on to the news. And we'll kick off the news with...
Can I just say before we start the news, I've got some news that I need to make sure you don't let me forget.
Say it now.
Go for it.
Go for it. Dive in. Be number one.
It's better at the end.
Is it the now Squirrel Girl's number one fan?
It's another Marvel mistake.
Okay. We need to remember that Steve has another news piece.
I'll do it now.
Do it now.
I don't know if any of you have been reading Civil War 2.
I haven't yet. Don't spoil it, though.
Oh.
Okay, do fine.
This definitely contains spoilers, so if you don't want to listen, then turn off now, or if you don't want me to say...
I have to edit the show, so I can't exactly just stop listening. So just say it, it's fine.
They kill off Bruce Banner.
Ooh, the unkillable man.
They kill him off dead. 50 years he's been going.
They kill him dead?
They kill him off.
You ruined it for
That's
me
That's up there with making Captain America Hydra.
That's Ben putting his headphones down.
He's gone to consult Squirrel Girl.
He's turning green. He's turning green.
He's not dead. He's here.
Oh my God, it's Kane.
Bruce Banner has just come in and announced that there's going to be a new Incredible Hulk and it's going to be Ben Cars. Ben's actually left the room, by the way.
He's actually gone.
Ben.
There is another Incredible Hulk.
Tell me that was a joke.
No, genuine. There is another Hulk.
Oh yeah?
In the storyline as well.
Is it Thaddeus Ross?
No.
So it's not the Red Hulk.
It's somebody new to me, but there is another Hulk.
Yeah.
Who carries on as the Hulk.
Yeah.
But Bruce Banner, see you bye.
No way.
And he didn't get killed by Squirrel Girl.
Was it somebody with tentacles who could get rid of the gamma radiation?
We just need to bear that in mind next week, that's all I'm saying.
Okay, why next
Taskmaster
week?
Taskmaster versus Hulk.
Oh.
Yeah.
It wasn't Taskmaster who killed him though, was it?
No, but we still need to bear it in mind. So okay. Yeah, that's what I just wanted to tell you. Civil War 2, newest episode out now.
Okay, so speaking of controversial changes in the Marvel Universe...
What a link.
Let's talk about the new Iron Man, who's actually going to still be called the new Iron Man, is actually going to be an Iron Girl.
15 years of
that's
age.
That's just weird.
Tony Stark, basically, he's retired. He's like, I want to go chill out for a bit. I'm going to give up being Iron Man. And he basically gives his legacy over to a girl called Riri Williams, who's a 15-year-old black girl. And... she's a genius. I can't remember like what her backstory was. I did read it, but it was a couple of weeks ago now. My question is, do you guys think that this is Marvel taking their diversity strategy one step too far? Because again, it's another...
Kamala Khan.
Yeah, exactly. It's another Kamala Khan.
I don't get it.
You just don't understand why they've done it, do you?
I don't understand.
I don't get... I've got no issue whatsoever with her being a girl. I've got no issue whatsoever with her being black. I just don't get
Iron Man.
How she can be 15.
Yeah.
She's not going to go out and fight to save the world.
I'm
and
just
save
saying
the
Squirrel
day.
Girl does it.
But that's something, exactly, it's ridiculous.
Yeah, so they've already made
this
that mistake.
This is the future. This
I just
is
don't
the future,
think, I know, obviously, we've seen recently Spider-Man.
Mm-hmm.
I just think 15. Nah, stay 15, in school, kids. Stay in school.
15 is the age to be.
Don't go out there and fight.
Are they going to create some new teams here?
Inappropriate uniforms.
With 15-year-olds here. Going to have, aren't they?
I just don't think she'd fit in the Iron Man suit for a start.
It just strikes me as, like, a massive change.
To be fair, the thing that annoys me the most, and I think I've probably said it before about something else that we've spoken about, but, okay, Riri Williams sounds like a great character, the fact that she's so intelligent, and she the other thing was that she makes these suits herself, like she makes her own suits. Why does she have to be Iron Man? Why can't she just be a
her
brand
own character?
Yeah, exactly. Why can't she just be a brand new superhero?
It's like football, like, isn't it, when they come on the scene and they're the next Messi.
With Iron Man's technology, because he's retired...
Sure,
she's just taken on Iron Man's legacy and she's her own character, whatever that may be.
And just
Iron
her,
Woman,
call
whatever.
Call her the Iron Maiden.
I said this the other day. It was the best name that you could possibly make for her.
They're not exactly going to do like a male version of the Black Widow either, are they? If they're going to do...
I think they probably have.
Oh, have they?
They've done like female and male versions of every single other character from other universes.
I didn't know that.
So I'd say that there maybe almost definitely will be a male Black Widow.
Homework.
There you go, then.
That is homework, yeah. Mm. Nath, please tell us next
maybe
week.
Maybe we could do that for a show. Female and male counterparts of each
one,
character.
Yeah.
That's a great show.
That's a great show. Yeah. Write that down. Get it written down. Yeah. Quick.
I can't. I'm hosting a show right now. Somebody else write it down.
Don't press draw because it actually lets you draw.
Does it actually?
Yeah,
it does.
On OneNote?
OneNote, yeah.
No way.
This isn't for the show, though. This is for after the show. Let's move on to the next news story, and that is about S.H.I.E.L.D. Just a quick note to say that Season 4, Episode 1 is set to air on the 20th of September.
3 days before my birthday. Happy birthday, Steve.
Why do you pair always get, like, Marvel birthday presents?
Because we love it.
You've got X-Men. He's getting S.H.I.E.L.D.
I got
your birthday,
Nate?
December, isn't it?
December, yeah.
Doctor Strange.
I think Strange was coming for you, but it's not.
No, it's not. It's too early.
One thing I did find interesting about this is, though, according to a site called Gaming Guide, this season of S.H.I.E.L.D. will focus on a growing conflict between Inhumans and X-Men. So...
I want to see the Inhumans. I've decided.
What?
Apparently, X-Men are going to be entering this universe.
I'm not sure how that's going to work, though There is more and more and more talk about them signing a deal with Fox, isn't there?
Well, maybe that's what... The last week we spoke about the possible... That Marvel were in talks with Fox about a crossover.
Maybe this is the crossover. Like the first stage of it, to see how it goes and see how it goes.
Well, there's been another news story this week to say that there's going to be another X-Men TV show. So, you know, we spoke about Legion, didn't we?
Yeah.
With Charles Xavier's,
Charles Xavier's son.
Apparently there's going to be another... X-Men TV show coming.
On what?
Don't know anything else, that's it.
Steve's opening it on the Disney Channel because he's already watching that one quite a lot.
What is it with you and the Disney Channel?
Other children's channels are available.
Yeah, so I just thought this could be a really interesting crossover in another like TV universe.
I am.
And Daisy Johnson's
like
coming
the sound
in pop.
Of that.
Just get
I need
out there.
To watch.
That is an important
I need to watch S.H.I.E.L.D. as it is, but that's making me want to watch it more.
Yeah, you definitely should do. I hope the X-Men series is done well as well, because I don't really know where they're going to go with it. But
Dan Stevens was the name I was looking for, by the way.
Dan Stevens.
He's the guy that's playing Xavier's son.
Oh, really? Okay, yeah. Cool. So moving on to much more important news, because it's about Captain Marvel.
Actually, Tom, that's all we've got time for this week.
Thanks for listening.
This is only a quick one, but it's been announced that the Captain Marvel comic will be getting a relaunch in 2017, according to The Hollywood Reporter. The author will be somebody called Margaret Stoll, who has written some other novels for Marvel previously, including a Black Widow novel.
I read this today, and what it actually is the new comic that's coming out in 2017 is a team-up comic with Squirrel Girl.
You're lying.
Just for you. We're going to do it. We're going to call it Captain Marvel and Squirrel Girl.
I'm not joking. Steve actually sent me the link at work and he said he didn't want to send it to you because he ruined it for you.
You're lying.
But it is actually...
You're a bad liar.
It's actually true.
What they're calling it is the beatable Captain Marvel and the unbeatable Squirrel Girl.
No, without the likeable Captain Marvel and the unlikeable Squirrel Girl.
There's like a little feature in as well, and it's featuring Tippy Toe.
Do you know what, actually, I did read this story because I actually read the next bit that you guys didn't, where actually it's Captain Marvel kills Squirrel Girl.
I'd be pretty up for that, to be fair.
Best, the best.
That's nuts, that is.
How many times can you use the same joke in one show?
I'll keep going. We can keep getting away with using nuts.
Yeah. I don't think Captain Marvel's got the teeth for it.
I think that's probably the tail end of these jokes. Okay, so on that note, that has been everything that we've got time for this week. You can find us on Twitter. We are at Marvel Matters. You can find us on Facebook, which is www.facebook.com/Marvel Matters. And on YouTube, we're youtube.com/Marvel Matters. Thank you very much for listening. We have been the Marvel Matters podcast featuring the spectacular Steve.
Flame on.
The benevolent Ben.
Bruce Banner smash.
The notorious Nath.
Squirrel Girl.
And I have been your host.
She's not a mouse.
The tremendous Tom. Thank you very much for listening, and we'll catch you next week. Goodbye.
Laters.
Bye.
See you, bye.
Bye-bye.